Good evening. Thanks so much for being here tonight. We have been looking forward to this night for a really long time, and we hope you have too. We are so excited to share with you the story of Jesus' birth, and not just his birth, but his entire life, his sinless life on this earth, his death for our behalf, and then his victorious resurrection from the grave. Tonight, we're telling the gospel story through song, and we are so excited about the message that we have to share with you tonight, and we're glad that you're here to share in that with us. I'm going to read a portion of scripture quickly, and then we're going to sing together, because this is a cooperative event. The Lord loves it when his people sing, and so we're all going to sing together in just a little bit. Hear the word of the Lord from Isaiah 11. There shall come forth a shoot from the stump of Jesse, and a branch from his roots shall bear fruit. And the Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord. And his delight shall be in the fear of the Lord. He shall not judge by what his eyes see, or decide disputes by what his ears hear. But with righteousness he shall judge the poor, and decide with equity for the meek of the earth. And he shall strike the earth with the rod of his mouth, and with the breath of his lips he shall kill the wicked. Righteousness shall be the belt of his waist, and faithfulness the belt of his loins. The wolf shall dwell with the lamb, and the leopard shall lie down with the young goat, and the calf and the lion and the fattened calf together, and a little child shall lead them. The cow and the bear shall graze, the young shall lie down together, and the lion shall eat straw like the ox. The nursing child shall play over the hole of the cobra, and the weaned child shall put his hand on the adder's den. They shall not hurt or destroy in all my holy mountains. For the earth shall be full of the knowledge of the Lord as the waters cover the sea. In that day, the root of Jesse, who shall stand as a signal for the peoples, of him shall the nations inquire, and his resting place shall be glorious. So not only is our Lord's resting place glorious, he is glorious, and we are thrilled to share that with you tonight. Let's stand to our feet this evening and let's sing together.
Joy has dawned upon the born of Mary. Sounds of wonder fill the sky with the songs of angels as the mighty Prince of Life shelters in a stable. Hands that set each star in place shake of men from distant lands prophesy the story. Gold, the king is born today. Incense, God is with us. Myrrh, his death will make a way, and by his blood he'll win us. Son of Adam, son of Heth, given as a ransom, reconciling God and man, Christ our mighty champion. What a Savior, what a friend, what a glorious mystery, once a babe in Bethlehem. a babe in Bethlehem. Now the Lord of history wants a babe in Bethlehem. Now the Lord of history. Christ the Lord of history.
You know, when the angels came and visited the shepherds, the Bible says that they said, "Glory in the highest and peace to all men upon whom God looks." The angels sang it then, they still sing it now about the Savior. Glory in the very highest. Let's sing this together.
You are the first, you go before. Glory in the highest. to dwell.
Amen. Amen. Emmanuel is here with us this evening. You can be seated.
Thank you.
I want to introduce you to some friends of mine, and they're a little shorter than I am. So guys, y'all come on up. This is the FBC Kids Choir, and they have been working real hard for the last several months with a couple of songs, and I know I did well because, one, they always ask to sing them, and two, they always leave our practice singing them. So if you're in the music business, you know that you're doing a good job when your people leave singing the songs you picked out. That's a really, really good thing. But I am so excited that they get to share a couple of songs with you. This song right now is a wonderful little song called More Than a Baby, and it gives the impression of a small child looking over the manger and seeing our Savior in the humblest form that we could possibly imagine. But they see much more than a baby.
Child like me, when I look into the manger, I see.
One of my favorite things at Christmas time, especially when I attend a Christmas program at a church, is a Christmas sing-along. I love to sing carols with believers that know why we sing these tunes. And so this next song is just that. It's a medley of carols that we've been singing for years and years and years, and carols that tell the story of Christ's birth. So let's stand to our feet together and let's sing.
Thank you.
I really, really love my job here. I get to work with all sorts of incredible people, including those little ones. I get to hang out with them every Sunday night. And this choir, I hang out with them every Wednesday night, every Sunday morning. I love them. I really do. They're great, and they work so hard. And these instrumentalists, I really am blessed to have such a great team of instrumentalists. But not all of the ones here tonight are here every week. So if you are a guest musician, would you please stand? If you're a guest musician, would you please stand? Would you give them a good Jones County welcome? They are coming from Georgia College and Mercer. And one of them still came from Georgia College, but he's still kind of a hometown boy, Mr. Billingsley. He didn't know whether to stand up or sit down. He doesn't really know what to do. But I really am blessed to work with a great group of people here. It's a joy to work here. We titled tonight's concert, Our God Has Come to Us. And that's really kind of a focal point on Emmanuel and Advent, all about God coming to be with us. And so we're about to sing our theme song tonight, and this is the part of the evening where we really start to explore the gospel story about how it didn't just stop with his birth. And while we should celebrate his birth every December, we should also remember that he wasn't just born. He lived a perfectly sinless life. He died on the cross for our sins and then rose triumphantly over the grave. And so tonight, I hope that you hear that gospel through song and through word. Here is Our God Has Come to Us.
Stars.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things were made through him, and without him, not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. The true light, which gives light to everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made through him, yet the world did not know him. He came to his own, and his own people did not receive him. But to all who did receive him, who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God, who were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. You know, at Christmas time, we like to tell stories. I've got CDs of just people narrating stories. And they're all really, really good. They're very inspirational. Some will make you cry, some will make you laugh. But there's no story like the story of Jesus. If you read everything about it, all the prophecies lined up. Caesar even declared that people had to be registered. So Jesus was born in Bethlehem. And Caesar said, you've got to go to your hometown to be registered. And so Joseph and Mary went to their hometown, Bethlehem. So God used a pagan man named Caesar to fulfill one of the greatest stories ever told. And tonight we are thrilled to share with you once again the greatest story ever told.
Tax law and a journey, a stable and some straw. These tell the greatest story ever told.
Money. When Logan read scripture just a moment ago, you heard, but to all who did receive him, who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God, who were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but he gave us the right to become children of God. You know, I think believing in God really is kind of easy. I can see nothing in all of creation that smacks of random. Everything to me looks like it's fairly complex. Today it exists. I don't see anything that exists totally and completely by chance, that it just happened. I think most everybody believes in some sort of creator. When you look at the polls that talk about who believes in God in the country, you'll hear 90% of the people believe in God. It's easy to believe in God. There's evidence. The hard part, I think, is in believing in a personal God, a God who is so real and is so a part of creation that he wants to enjoy a relationship with me. He wants to enjoy a relationship with you. Now, why would he want to do, how could he do that? 7 billion people in the world. Think of how many billions of people that have lived over the whole course of the existence of humanity. It boggles the mind. And I believe that's exactly why there was a manger. I don't know that there's anybody in the world that doesn't understand a baby. Heaven's to Betsy. All of us go crazy when you get around a baby. You'll get adults who are grizzled old people that are grumpy to everybody in the world, and they get around a baby, and all of a sudden it's ooh and ah and coo. And it's a baby. It's a baby. There's nothing more personal than a baby. There's nothing that draws you close like a baby. And I sort of look at it, it's almost like this, that God sort of stood back. You know, he was involved, but he gave the Ten Commandments, and he said, okay, guys, go to it. And the guys worked and hard, and they did everything they could. They couldn't ever quite get it right. And he finally said, look, guys, that's enough. Let me show you what I mean here. So he sent a baby. He sent his baby. And when you look at his baby, you saw God. Let that sink in a second. You've looked at babies before, and you've looked at the mom or you looked at the dad, and you go, I know where that child comes from. When we see this baby, we see God. We saw how he lived, how he grew. We saw and heard what he said. We saw what he did. We watched as he gave up everything, including his life. He died, was buried, but on the third day of his death, God said, that's enough. That's enough. And Jesus incredibly, miraculously, almost unbelievably came back to life to make a point. This is how much I love you. This is how much I love you. I love you enough that my son lived a perfect life to show you what it looks like and to help you understand that you can't do it. No matter how hard you try, you can never live that perfect life. I love you enough that I poured out the punishment that everyone who has ever disobeyed anything that I have ever said, and that's been everybody. And I did it so who would believe on my son, on Jesus, to everyone who would trust on Jesus, who will stake their life on the fact that Jesus is their Savior, we can be saved. It is still the greatest story ever told. Paul told Timothy, the saying is trustworthy and deserving of full acceptance, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am the foremost. He came for you, and he came for me. Glory be to God.
Would you stand as we sing together?
Christ alone, my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are stilled, when striving cease. My comforter, my all in all, here in the love of Christ I stand. In Christ alone.
Certainly hope you have seen Jesus tonight and that you have heard his gospel preached, you have heard it sung, you have sung it together. Until he returns, here in his power, we shall stand. We hope that this leads you into the middle of the Advent season as you look forward to celebrating Christmas with your families. We're going to sing one more song together and then we'll let you go. But it's been so good to have you here tonight. We hope you've enjoyed your time. Let's go out singing together.
Christ is come.
may the love of God, the peace of Christ, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be yours this holiday season and into the new year. Merry Christmas, everybody.